Greetings, this is another flashlight review by the flashlight reviewer Selfbuilt. Today I'm looking at a new high output thrower light by Crelant, the 7G5. As you can see, it's a substantial size light with a fairly large head. Obviously a 2x18650 style light, or 4xCR123A in this format. Overall body is fairly smooth, although there is reasonable knurling. It's not that aggressive on the handle. With the other design elements, overall grip is certainly fairly decent, although maybe not as high as some other lights. If we start at this end, you can see there's a fairly large, deep reflector there, smooth for maximum throw, with a cool white XML emitter at the base of it. So we can get that to focus a little better for you. So I would expect excellent throw out of this light, as long as it's driven to a reasonable level. The tail cap is a forward clicky switch, which has a built-up area so the light can actually tail stand. It can, of course, headstand too, and there are crenellations here on the bezel so that if you put the light upside down and turn it on, you can see light escaping so you know that it's on. The interface is very straightforward. Click the switch to turn on, or press for momentary. You advance modes by doing exactly that, pressing through momentary modes or clicking on and off. So there's the high mode, there's the low mode, there's the strobe mode. So back to high, low, strobe. Maybe I'll see that a little bit better here. There's high, there's low, there's strobe. As you might imagine, that's a very fast strobe. It's about 16 hertz, one of the fastest ones I've seen. Overall build is certainly a good size, fairly solid. If I open this up, I'm happy to see trapezoidal or square cut threads, very clear there. What's interesting about the light too, tail cap of course is a fairly standard clicky, is it comes with a built-in battery tube extender. So you could run it on a couple of less batteries, or a couple of 18500s, or 3xCR123A, and again, the same square cut anodized thread, which gives you a tail cap lockout. So all in all, not a bad sort of overall budget build. Reminds me somewhat maybe of the JetBeam BC40. I think it's about the same price point, only this one, of course, is a much greater thrower than that light was, given its overall design. If you want to see exactly how it performs compared to the competition, you can go to my flashlight at flashlightreviews.ca, where you'll find links to all my reviews on Candle Power forums, where I post them in the reviews forum under the username Selfbuilt. Thank you very much. Hope you found that useful.